I am Moses Barua from Educare, and we are proceeding by solving different nectar questions in our subject geography. And today we are going to solve Nectar 2021, specifically question number 7. The question states that study the following photograph carefully and then answer the question that follow. Today's question is not an S-type question. Is about photograph interpretation, or we say photo interpretation, and the candidate is supposed to study the provided or the given photograph carefully and then to answer the question that follow. Here we may read those question and then we'll go to see the given photograph and then we'll start to answer one question after another. Now the question says that study carefully the following photograph. Careful, study the following photograph carefully and then answer the question that follow. Question number one says that state the position of a photographer when taking a photograph. Question number two asks that describe the settlement pattern in the middle ground of the photograph. Question number three states that with evidence give us a reflection of the area in the foreground. The fourth question states that give 4 points, describe function of vegetation shown in the area. And the last question is asked that suggest two types of economic activities taking place in the area. So the first question needs a candidate to show the position of photograph when taking a photograph. The second question needs a candidate to describe settlement pattern in the middle ground of the photograph, not the whole photograph, just in the middle. The third one needs a candidate to give us the reflection of the area in the foreground by giving evidence. The first one need a candidate to describe a function of vegetation in the area, shown in the area. And the last one, a candidate supposed to suggest at least two types of economic activities by giving evidence in a provided photograph. Now, let us see a given photo here, as it is seen here. At the of our photo here, we see there are some tracks. But also there are some container. At the middle, there are settlement here and some vegetation trees. But at the back of our photograph here, we have mountain. So here, a candidate is supposed to study that photograph careful and then to answer the previous question. Na tunasema kwamba kwenye haya maswali ya photo, mara nyingi huwa mchawi ni macho yako mwenyewe. Kile ambacho utakiona kama macho yako yanakudanganya basi utakuwa umefeli mwenyewe. Na inabidi mwanafunzi aitizame picha kwa makini, angalie mbele anakiona nini, katikati anaona nini na nyuma ya picha anaona nini. Baada ya hapo, student will be in a good position of answering those asked question. So that is our photo and here we are going to answer one question after another. The first question asks that state the position of a photographer when taking a photograph. And the answer is that the position of a photographer when taking a photograph was the front view at the elevated angle, maybe in a high building or mountain or aircraft. Here, we ask you to show the position of a photographer when taking a photograph. Here, we say that in the front view, and maybe a photographer may be in an elevated angle, either in a high building, aircraft, or in a mountain. And why we say that? Because we see that the photographer, tunasema kwamba photographer hawezi kuchukua picha akiwa katika huu mlima ambao umekatwa, ama hawezi kuwa kwa pembeni huku, ila hapa kutokana na picha ilivyokaa, photographer lazima atakuwa alikuwa mbele. Sio tu kwamba alikuwa mbele, bali alikuwa katika sehemu ambayo imenyanyuka kidogo, either kama ni kajimlima ama alikuwa kwenye ndege ambayo iko kwenye level ya chini au alikuwa kwenye jengo refu. Tunaona kwamba position ambayo ameweza kuchukua hii picha ni sehemu ya mbele akiwa kwenye mwinuko kidogo tofauti na sehemu ambayo anachukua picha. And that is why we see the some top of the features and the side view. That means that the picture is low oblique. So we say that a photographer lazima atakuwa alikuwa mbele katika sehemu ambayo imeinuka kidogo. So tumejibu hili swali linalosema kwamba state the position of a photographer when taking a photograph, kusema kwamba the position of a photographer when taking a photograph of the front view at the elevated angle, maybe in a high building, mountain, or aircraft? So that is the first question. The second question asks that, describe the settlement pattern in the middle ground of the photograph. And after making a photograph interpretation here, we say that settlement pattern of the middle ground part of the photograph is nucleated or clustered settlement, nuclear or clustered settlement, because buildings are nearby each other. And here, because this is photograph, now let us see the settlement pattern at the middle of ground for our photo. Yes, here in our photo we see at the middle, you see buildings are nearby each other. So that's why we see that the type of or the pattern of settlement here is nuclear or clustered, because we see in our photograph at the middle of the photograph, settlement pattern or building are near by each other. They are constructed nearby each other. It is not scattered, but also it is not linear. So automatically it is a nuclear settlement or clustered type of settlement. So that's why we say that the pattern of a settlement in the middle ground is nuclear settlement. Yes, question number three asks that, with evidence, give us three fraction of the area in the foreground. With evidence, give us three fraction of the area in the foreground. We say that garage, the first fraction we say that garage workshop for truck services. And the evidence is that this is due to the presence of container, yard, and trucks. Kwa hiyo tunasema kwamba kazi ya sehemu ambayo imeonyeshwa katika eneo la mbele la picha. Kazi ya kwanza tunasema kwamba hapa kuna kazi ya gereji, ambako tunaona kwamba gereji kwa ajili ya kutoa huduma kwa yale maroli ambayo yamepaki pale. Na hii ime be evidence di kwenye photograph baada ya kuona kwamba kuna container ya disemo ambako analala makontena, lakini pia kuna nini, kuna hizi trucks, kuna haya maroli. Kwa hiyo tunaona kwamba kazi ya kwanza ambayo inawezekana ikawa ina take place ama faction ambayo inaweza ikawa ina take place kwenye photograph katika eneo la mbele, ya kwanza kabisa tunazungumzia gereji workshop for truck service. Lakini ya pili tunazungumzia transportation faction, kazi za usafirishaji, and that is due to the presence of container yard and trucks. Kwa hiyo tunazungumzia kwamba hapo kuna masuala ya usafirishaji, kwa sababu yale makontena pale automatically kwamba amepelekwa na mashaki, lakini pia mashaki hapo kwa ajili ya kuchukua kuyapeleka sehemu nyingine. So we say that there are transportation faction. Na faction ya mwisho ya tatu tunasema kwamba settlement, this is due to the presence of house in the right view of the photograph. Katika upande wa kulia tunaona kwamba kuna nyumba upande wa mbele kabisa wa picha. Kwa hiyo inaonyesha kwamba pia eneo lile linatumika kama makazi ya watu. So we say settlement faction. So that is how a student may answer this question by giving evidence that is clearly shown on your photograph. And another question here asks that, give 4 points, describe faction of vegetation shown in the area. As we see that when we are interpreting our photograph, we say that there is vegetation, there is trees at the middle, but also back of background of our photograph. So those faction or those vegetation have different faction. As we know that first of all, vegetation prevents soil erosion in the area. And here we talk about those trees that seen in the photograph that may help to prevent soil erosion in the photograph area. Tunasema kwamba kazi ya hapa tukizungumzia vegetation tunazungumzia uoto. Sasa pale kuna miti, lakini pia miti katikati ya picha na nyuma kule ya picha kuna uoto mwingine. Kwa hiyo tunasema kwamba hiyo vegetation ni kazi yake kubwa ya kwanza ni kuprevent soil erosion. Tunajua kwamba kule juu, kule nyuma ya picha kuna mlima. Kule mlima automatically mvua zikinyesha lazima kuna maji ambayo yanaporomoka kule. Sasa kama hakuna vegetation kama vile, ingekuwa erosion ina take place kwa kiasi kikubwa. Sasa kazi ya kwanza hii miti pale ama ile vegetation ni kuprevent ili eneo from soil erosion. Faction, the second faction we say that vegetation like trees in the area act as a windbreaker. As we know that Wind blows from the area with high pressure to the area with low pressure. So if the difference is high, the speed of the wind increase. Kama eneo lina pressure kubwa sana na lingine lina pressure ndogo sana, basi speed ya upepo itakuwa ni kubwa. Na obviously tunajua impact ya upepo ukiwa mkubwa unaweza kuleta maafa, kuharibu properties mbalimbali na pini pia kusababisha matatizo makubwa. Kwa hiyo miti ambayo iko pale ina act as a wind breaker. So kama wind uta blow from one region with high pressure to another region with low pressure kwa high speed, hii miti ita act as a wind breaker. Kwa hiyo itapunguza speed ya nini? Ya ule upepo na hatimaye uta minimize the impact of wind. Another function of vegetation in the area, we see that the habitat of birds and other organisms. As we know that vegetation like trees provide habitat to birds and other organisms. Ndege huwa hawaishi kwenye nyasi wala hawaishi kwenye nyumba za binadamu, bali wenyewe huwa wanaishi kwenye miti. Kwa hiyo nasema kwamba vegetation ya pale ina provide habitat for other organism. But the last one, you see that control and modify climate of one area. Here we know that vegetation is responsible for rainfall formation, but also we know that in areas where the vegetation is, the climate is modified, either you may find that that area experience low temperature due to vegetation that found in that area compared to areas where there is no vegetation. For instance, in desert area, you know that in desert area the climate is very harsh and there are high temperature because there is no vegetation. So the vegetation in the photo area act as a factor that modify a climate of that area. So that is the function of vegetation showing in the area. And the last question here says that suggest types of economic activity taking place in the area. So here a candidate is supposed to suggest two types of economic activities taking place in the area. And here a student must suggest the function or economic activities that seem to take place in the area, not any economic activities, but you're supposed to refer on the given photograph. And here we say that the first function, economic types, there is transportation activities. And that is due to the presence of container yard, trucks and roads. So we see that kuna shughuli ya kiuchumi kama usafirishaji, kwa sababu hapo kuna masuala ya makontena, sehemu ya kuwekea makontena, kuna hayo maroli, lakini pia kuna barabara. Kwa hiyo automatically ni kwamba shughuli za usafirishaji hapo zina take place. The second function is industrial activities. Here we talk about shughuli za viwanda, manufacturing industry. This is due to the presence of industrial roads and track which help in transportation of goods and raw material. Na kwa sababu gani tuseme kwamba hapa kuna industrial activities? Tunaona kwamba kwenye picha ambayo tumepewa kuna industrial roads, lakini pia kuna hizi truck ambazo zinasaidia katika transportation of goods and raw material. Na yale makontena pale yamewekwa karibu, hii ikisuggest kwamba kuna industrial activities ambazo zina take place. Tumeambiwa tutaje two types of economic activities, but also there are other activities that may happen in a photograph. So a candidate may also use this business activities. You see that there are roads, transportation, movement of people, settlement. So obviously business activity may take place. But also we have agricultural activities. Here we see at the middle and at the back of the photograph, there are high space, there are enough space for conducting agricultural activities. So that a student may answer by referring what is seen in the photograph. And after seeing those five questions that ask in our photograph, this marks the end of our session. Let us meet on the next session.